Nice snappy jab off the bell out of that southpaw stance for Rittewada and a cutting side kick.
Yeah, Rittewada is coming out very aggressive, immediately starting to utilize those right side weapons to try to find a hole. This is always interesting when two southpaw strikers face off because they're used to sparring and practicing with right-sided athletes.
Saemapetch attempting a check hook there as Rittewada launched himself in. Saemapetch did tell us he wanted to feel that Rittewada for the first 3 minutes and look to finish him in the second round. Rittewada said, I'll get on the inside and elbow him all night long. Teep there from Rittewada and a good switch roundhouse kick.
Yeah, Rittewada's immediately starting to go after that push kick, and he's also backing Saemapetch up, which is different from last time. Nice little right hand to beautiful little check leg kick right there.
Rittewada cutting off the circle, fake there from Saemapetch. Outside leg kick from Rittewada, just above the lead knee of Saemapetch. Rittewada does have the reach advantage. Outside leg kick from Saemapetch. He'll want to rely on his hands mostly tonight. Saemapetch, nice footwork, just got out of dodge and drifts closer to center circle.
Yeah, it's a good idea for Saemapetch to keep his back off of the wall, because what happened last time is when he got his back up against the wall, he couldn't go anywhere when that elbow came straight for his face.
Nice check of the leg kick there from Saemapetch halfway through the opening round. Once again, three judges circle side are scoring on a 10-point must system. They'll give the winner of the round 10 points, the loser 9 or less.
Rittewada did say there was something special coming in this matchup, and there is a little bit more venom in each one of his shots.
Friends, how are you liking Live 1 Super Series Muay Thai for the first time ever?
World class. I mean, it helps when you got two of the best ever to do it right here. And, you know, the most impressive thing for me is the diversity of the cards. I mean, submission grappling earlier, you get this, and then you get heavyweights and featherweights in MMA.
Nice high check from Rittewada, goes downstairs, attacking that lead leg of Saemapetch. One way to slow down a boxing heavy opponent is to kick out the legs. All good punches begin from the bottom of the feet, work their way through the legs, up the body, exit through the knuckles. So if you can take out the legs, you can slow down the boxing.
Saemapetch doing a good job of utilizing the lateral footwork when Rittewada really tries to close that distance. He's got to get a little bit more active with the hands. I like the check right there, but he's got to start attacking. Right now, he's just kind of defending.
Oh, there it is. Snappy cross off the left hand from Rittewada. Good leg kick to the lead thigh again, hitting the lower part of the quadriceps. 10 seconds remains.
Good opening round for Rittewada.
Action, let's go.
Oh, a stiff 1-2 from Rittewada. And there's the jab again from Rittewada. It's all scoring technique. And the final 10 seconds. And on my unofficial scorecard, that locks it in 10-9
yeah,
for Rittewada.
That was some crisp little boxing he showcased right there with that head movement.
Folks, don't forget, head to One-Dot Shop. Shop from premium everyday basics to training essentials exclusively at One-Dot Shop. What a match from inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. As we take a look at this again here, you see Rittewada just slides forward on that lead foot and the sliding jab threads it through the defenses. Hooked to an outside leg kick there from Saemapetch, dropped his lead hand, and immediately Rittewada backed him up. That, again, unofficially, I say a clear 10-9 round for Rittewada. Saemapetch said he had to be the aggressor. Rittewada acknowledged that Semipet's punches are accurate and fast. They were his greatest concern. But he's closed them down so far as Rittewada, who opens up the jab and a high right roundhouse.
Saemapetch's got to put that pedal down. He's got to shift gears and really start to go to work here, because Rittewada is starting to find his groove and he's also starting to understand his range. What we saw at the end of the first is he was coming in, attacking, moving his head slightly out of line, and then coming right back.
Oh, jab to overhand left there from Rittewada. Now the heavy artillery. Saemapetch trying to find a range with that lead hand, turns it into a hook on that occasion. There's some reddening on the outside of the calf of the lead leg of Saemapetch, courtesy of Rittewada's leg kicks.
Rittewada's really starting to go to work with that jab. And he's doing a good job of utilizing the push kick too. Saemapetch has to counter off that push kick. Nice little cut kick right there as he went after the support leg.
High kick from Rittewada. Getting in closer and closer as the seconds tick down. Is he going for elbow range, Rittewada? Trying to break down that forearm.
But what I'm seeing is the biggest difference from Rittewada. Yes, he's putting a lot more spice into his shots, but he looks thicker, Michael.
He does.
He's added that strength and conditioning program. He looks like he's heavily muscled up, and he's really starting to utilize that jab well.
Looks for the inside fighters, Rittewada. Saemapetch on the outside. Oh, and the big kibosh! It's good night, Irene! Saemapetch knocks out Rittewada! How about that?
And just like that, Saemapetch Fairtex can shut my mouth as he shut the lights out on Rittewada. What a shot!
Prince Dover, how about that for a Muay Thai knockout? Your circle side for that one.
Incredible. I'm speechless right in front of us here. You see the absolute violence in this sport on display right there.
Perfectly threaded overhand left. He was out before he even hit the canvas. This is perfection. This is highlight reel. This is brilliant. The precision, the accuracy, and the power of Saemapetch Fairtex.
It was that kind of domination in the first matchup.
It really
right?
was, but this time he finished the job as he said he would. What did he say? It was prophetic. He said, I'll feel him out in the first round, I'll knock him out in the second round. And that's exactly what Saemapetch did. A Nostradamus performance from Saemapetch.
About to get another shot at the world title with that one right there.
Oh yeah, if he can get another crack at Nongo, that's provided Nongo's still the champion after tomorrow, of course, because he takes on Liam Harrison in defense of the crown. Look at this again. Drop the right arm, did Rittewada. That's the only opening that Saemapetch needed.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Justin Brown, has called a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 35 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of knockout, Saemapetch!